to do when you're out here alone. But listen to the radio till daylight breaks, hoping they play something that'll keep you awake. The whole night trucker station came to an end, but behold, a new savior stepped right in. Thank God for the satellite and radio. For good trucking music, there's a place to go. Bill, Mac, and Cindy, and Dave Nemo. Thank God for...
good morning, guys. Look at that. The sun is starting to get up. It's starting to get some light out there. And I am ready to go over to my pickup location. It's here about 6:36 right now. So we're just getting ready. They open at 7 o'clock and we got 8 miles to go. So we'll head over there and pick up our load and get out of Louisiana. Make our way home. So let's get down there. And thank you guys for joining us today. And hopefully we will have an awesome day today. Alrighty guys, we are at the customer. As you guys can probably see, I'm in the dock. Got the red light and they are loading me right now. This place is actually pretty fast with loading usually, you know. Usually doesn't take them very long to get loaded and all that. Usually though in the morning if I get here at 7 a.m. and get loaded right away, it takes a little while for the office to get the customs invoice because they got to get it from a different office. So sometimes I've had to wait here for about an hour before I get my invoice, but we'll see how it goes today. Today is Tuesday, so they are expecting me here. So hopefully they do have that invoice ready today. Let's keep our fingers crossed. And if that's the case, we can hightail out of here and we could be home Thursday night if everything goes according to plan. So I would really appreciate that. I like that if that was the case. But anyways, let's get loaded here. And they actually got a scale just around the trailers there. You can't really see it from here, but they actually do have a scale up there. And we'll scale her and we'll see what we look like. Anyways, that's I guess we'll see you guys in a little bit. Alrighty guys, we got loaded. Now it's just a matter of getting it scaled out. I'm gonna try and get as close to the edge over here as I can possibly make it. Yeah. Here we go. Because it's always a little bit of a challenge getting onto this scale here, so gotta be all the way on here on the edge in order to actually get onto the scale here, you know. Well, we'll make it happen. Looks like we are like 836. I don't know if it's 8 pounds and 36 or whatever. Let's see what our damage is gonna be today. Actually, we're not looking too shabby. Looking pretty good there. So, let's see if we can get on here, no problem. It's a really skinny scale too. Alright, okay. Let's do the calculation here and see what our calculator will say what we are at. Sitting at 45,940 minus my steer axle. So we're sitting at 33,640. That's actually pretty good. I'm actually going to be able to scale this legal. I think so. Anyways, let's see what the total will be, but looking pretty good so far. Well, it took them a little longer today to get me loaded than usual, I think, but just have a look. Completely on the scale now. Alright, we're sitting at 78,740. Okay, 78,740 minus 33,640. Huh? What? Oh, this is not right. 78,740 minus, all right, minus We're sitting at 32,800 on the trailer, so we're actually pretty darn good. We're not overweight at all. That's perfect. Just the way I like it. Good deal. Yeah, we are still on the property, so that's why I'm not wearing a seatbelt. So just getting off the ski, you know. Alright, so let's go get our paperwork. I always make sure I scale it before I go get my paperwork, so that way I can say, okay, yes, I am legal to go. So let's get out of here. I gotta go to the front office to go get my paperwork. And it's always like that, and I just really hope that they'll have my customs ready today. Hope I don't have to wait for that. I already got here at 7 o'clock this morning, and it's already 8:35. So by the time we get our paperwork, it might be 9 o'clock by the time we get out of here today, you know. Which I was hoping I could get out of here earlier, but... yeah, well, it's okay. We can still get some miles in as long as they have our paperwork ready. So all we gotta do is we usually go behind these other trucks that you see parked up here. And we just park there and go inside and get our paperwork. So let me go ahead and park here and then we'll see you guys down the road. Here we go, guys. Our paperwork was ready. So we didn't have to wait to get our paperwork. Very, very nice people in here. Yeah. That's probably just a satellite about my border crossing info. I'm eating some omelet chocolates. They had some chocolates for sale there. I love these kind of chocolates, so I said, I gotta have some. Yep. But here we go. Now we are officially on our way home. Yes, sir. And we got good weights. We got about 1,600 miles to go to home, or a little over 1,600. That's a good trip. It's going to be a good round trip anyways, you know. I'd figured about 3,600 mile round trip anyways, right? So let's get on down the road and have ourselves an awesome day. Well, guys, here we are in swampland of Louisiana. Yes, sir, Bob, it is. I've been driving for a couple of miles on this bridge or whatever you want to call it. It's so swampy, I guess, up here that the Whiskey Bay, that's where I'm at right now. Whiskey Bay. Yeah, look at that. That's a nice little river there, eh? But anyways, I was just going to say, it's so swampy up here that they got to build this whole highway on like a bridge. Otherwise, I guess the ground is not supporting the highway or whatever you want to call it. But up here a little further down the road, I think you'll even see a little bit of water there on the side. I don't know if the camera is going to be able to pick it up, but yeah, look at this. I mean, we're literally on... in the air somewhere, you know. But anyways, I just figured I had to show this to you guys. I know I've shown this part before a little bit, you know, but we do have a lot of new subscribers on here again, and you know, doesn't hurt in my opinion to show it every once in a while, right? At least that's what I think. Yeah, up here you'll be able to probably see a little bit of water. Maybe not, the camera will probably not pick it up there, but between this highway and the other highway, there is actually water underneath there. I can actually see it. Yeah, that's quite interesting. But anyways, we're having our ourselves a fantastic day today. It's nice and sunny, not windy at all, just a nice day to be out here cruising along the highway, that's for sure. But we are making our way over to I-49. We'll take that over there north towards Paris, and then we'll go slowly up that way home. But anyways, we'll see you guys all a little bit later.
There's miles and miles of trucks rolling end to end. What a sight to see. How did it all begin? Corporal Norm said, help me. So the drivers all pitched in, and with hearts of gold, they hit the road for his special friends. Now there's a little piece of heaven brought with every load, when those highway angels come to spread their wings. The world's largest truck convoy rolling down the road, to that special athlete, it means everything. They all come together the same time every year. From coast to coast, north to south, they graciously appear, bringing hope and lots of love, loaded on 18 wheels. They'll jam some gears and shed some tears to show how truckers feel. There's a little piece of heaven brought with every load, when those highway angels come to spread their wings. The world's largest truck convoy rolling down the road, to that special athlete, it means everything. Well, the humming of the engines, the blowing of the horns, the black smoke filling up the air, it's the greatest show on earth. Imagine what it's worth to that smiling face who sees someone that cares. There's a little piece of heaven brought with every load, when those highway angels come to spread their wings. The world's largest truck convoy rolling down the road, to that special athlete, it means everything. Yeah, the world's largest truck convoy rolling down the road, to that special athlete, it means everything.
A fantastic day doing it. Yeah, we're just turning on to I-20 westbound, heading towards Dallas, but we're not actually going to go all the way to Dallas. No sir.
Continue on this road for 7 miles.
Yeah, I just chose to go this way for a reason. I like to go on this road. It seems to be much smoother road the way I'm driving right now than if I would have taken another road, you know. But we've got a few hours behind us already, and we got a few more hours to go too. Yep. Yeah, at least it's nice and green up here. I talked to my buddy there earlier, and he says up there in Canada, he says, the trees are starting to turn yellow and the leaves are starting to fall off. And up here it's nice and green, beautiful. Truck shows 31 degrees right now. I don't feel that inside of the cab here because I got my temperature set the way I like it, right? But yeah, I set my GPS up to go over to Paris. So that way I take that highway and then I take 271. Take that across all the way up there to Topeka. Well, I don't know if it's all the way to 71 up there, but somewhere up there I'll hit that 75, US 75, and I'll take that across over to US 29. And that just seemed to be one of the best ways to go, in my opinion. Like I said before, it's better routing, I think, but we'll see. We'll see. Anyways, we're just cruising along here. I'm gonna stop here somewhere soon, I think, though. To find me a truck stop somewhere. We have my half an hour mandatory break here somewhere. And we'll continue on with our journey. Here we go, guys. We just had ourselves a little bit of a pit stop.
57 miles.
Here at this path right here to the left. Yeah. Had ourselves a bite to eat over there. And yep. Now we're gonna go put the hammer down and see up to where we will make it tonight. Haven't really figured out exactly where I'm gonna make it at tonight, but eventually we'll figure it out, right? I think so. But I want to drive a few hours yet today. Yeah. Got a long way to go yet, so would like to do at least 200 more miles today, which is probably about 3.5 hours worth of driving, so yep. So let's put the hammer down and see what happens, right? There we go. We just went on to a back road highway, a US 80, taking that across over to Marshall, or at least to the bypass or whatever you want to call it. Yep, it's just absolutely gorgeous up here in the back roads of Texas. And yes, we just did enter Texas again. We were only in Texas last week. Here we are again. You know, or maybe the week before we were in Texas, I guess. Last week we were sort of coming back to Canada and then cruise off a couple of days there last week, I guess. And so now it's already Tuesday in the new week, so yeah, look at this, eh? Completely different. I love Texas, I really do. Beautiful, beautiful sceneries up here. Beautiful trees, bush, really nice. I love a nice forest, you know, nice big forest. I love it. And here we go, let's just put the hammer down and go a little different routing than what I am used to. I figured I'd try something new. You guys ever feel like trying something new? I do every once in a while. I like to change things up every once in a while, so I get to see something new. You know, I get a new experience. Yes. But that's the way it goes. So I guess we are here in the Oklahoma state. Yeah, we are on the Indian Nation Turnpike, which in essence I think is well, 271, I believe it, the highway number is. It's a toll highway and I don't have their Oklahoma pass, so we gotta pay cash, $5.75 this time, I guess. That's what it says up there. And toll booth is just coming up over there, so I guess we'll have to pay a toll again. I already had to stop once and pay a toll, like $6, $5.75 over here. So yeah, I guess we'll just have to grab a 20. Give him a 20, probably. Yeah. I don't have a 5 or a 6. Yeah. The whole part of the job, I guess. Yeah. Well, we are almost done for today. At least I think.
Reduced ahead.
I think we are almost done for today.
Speed limit reduced ahead.
Yes, RJ, I know. I know I gotta slow down and stop here and pay my toll. Yep, that's right. Huh? We gotta take care of that, right? Here we go. Gorgeous day out here today. It's a gorgeous day out here today. I live up in Canada and it's supposed to be pretty cool over there already. Alrighty.
You have a good day.
We'll try. There you go. Paying our dues. Good to go. We get a receipt. That's right. Supposedly there's supposed to be a rest area up here somewhere, according to the GPS at least. Now, I don't know if there is more toll road, toll highways, or toll booths up here yet or not, but I guess we'll just have to find out. Yeah, well, we had a good day, we really did. We got some good miles in already. Now I'm just gonna have to find me a place to park. I mean, I still have some time that I can drive, but I only have like 1100 miles to go already and I would be home, you know. I figure I can do that easily tomorrow and the day after, so find me a parking spot here pretty soon and we will call it a day. We'll pull over and, oh boy, it's slowed it down to 45, all right. I guess then we'll try and go 45. But anyways, as I was saying, I don't really have to go too much further. I could actually just stop right now and I would be all right, you know. And that was my plan from the beginning. If I could make it far enough today, then I could make it home there by Thursday evening, you know. And it looks like it's going to turn out that way, unless I have any problems. Then, you know, things can always change, but the way it looks like right now, everything is looking pretty good to be on track, you know. The sun is starting to go lower too, so might be just time to stop pretty soon. So we'll see what we find. I don't know, I don't see no signs of rest areas yet, but I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Well guys, here we go. Looks like we found ourselves a rest area. This rest area is in the center between the highways. And usually that's the way they got it on toll highways, you know. It was $1.99 for gas. I can't believe how cheap it's got, you know. Let's see if we can find ourselves some parking in here. I think this is a brand new rest area because my GPS doesn't even have this rest area in here. The GPS says I think another 20 or 25 miles are supposed to be a rest area, but doesn't show any rest area for up here. But we'll see. Yeah, looks like we got parking in here. Yeah, should be no problem parking in here. I think I want to go park over there. Here it looks a little bit on an angle like that, so if I can go park over there, it might be a little straighter. Yeah, it looks like a brand spanking new rest area, that's for sure. I think we're just gonna pull her in right over here. Yep, I think that one over there is full already, so we'll just pull her in right over here and we'll be good, be done for today. Yeah. Yes, that's it. Right there, so there you go. We are done, finito for today, yeah. Finito. All right, so we'll do our things and then we'll see you guys a little bit later. Well, guys, we are finished. I just finished editing my video for yesterday and now we're done. We are ready to go to bed. It's gotten dark outside already, so yeah, it is time to go to bed and get up early tomorrow morning. We're just taking a 10-hour break and we are hauling ass out of here. Yes, we got about, well, 1,780 kilometers to go to home. That's a little bit, around 1,100 miles, maybe a little more, but somewhere around that area. But still supposed to be pretty warm overnight up here, so I'm going to have to leave my AC on my APU unit, but... hey, so we should be able to get home Thursday night or Thursday early evening, you know. But that's about all I got today. How did you guys' day go? You guys all had a good day? Or I guess if you watch it in the morning, I guess your day has just started. But how is it so far? How's it been so far anyways? If it has been good or whatever, give me a good comment down there below. Let me know how your day went. Yeah, my day went excellent. I had a fantastic day. So with that, have a good one everybody, and we shall see you again tomorrow. It's time to get going, it's time to move on. What's this behind me? That day is gonna come.